This is the solution to quiz two. Okay, so cosine of pi over 6 is square root 3 over 2, and sine of pi over 6 is half. As a result, r pi over 6 is square root 3 over 2 half negative half square root 3 over 2. Okay, part I. That's E1. That's E2. So, this here, that's r pi over 6 applied to E1, and this one, that column, is r pi over 6 applied to E2. So they've been rotated pi over 6. So if this is angle pi over 6, then RE1 looks something like that. RE2 that, and the whole figure. Something like that. Again, this is not an art class. Okay, well, the story is just a silly story. It's saying, more or less, just this picture here, that if it took 5.1 liters of paint to paint that, and then we turned it slightly sideways, it would still take 5.1 liters. Because rotating something doesn't change its area. And then the determinant of these, the determinant of r theta for any theta, in fact, will be cosine of theta squared, and then because of the negatives, we'll get add sine of theta squared, which is of course 1. And that makes sense because rotations preserve area. Oh, lovely. Okay. So we've got points from x's and y's are negative 2 all the way up to x's and y's are positive 2. So let's see if I can get some of the easy ones first. So I'll do all the ones with zeros. So when any time that x is 0, is pretty easy. So this one is fixed. This is x is 0 and y is 1. So that goes here. This one is x is 0 and y is 2. So this one, like that. That one is fixed. X is 0 and y is negative 1, so this one goes that way. And x is 0 and y is. Okay, so that looks good. There's some easy ones going the other direction, I think. So y is 0 here, x squared. So that'll be 1. And then this is x is 2, so x squared, so that'll be 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Then, similarly, y is 0 here. X is negative 1, but we're going to square it, so it goes that way. And this one, again, x is negative 2, y is 0, so it goes, how far? 2, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Okay. So those are the easy ones. So I'll try some of these in blue here. Okay, so x is 2 and y is 1, so we're gonna go over 4 and up 1. Okay, similarly for this one, we're gonna go over 4 to the right by 4 and up 2. Okay, and then these ones down here will be symmetric. Over 4, down 1. Over 4, down 2. Okay, good. So this one will be over... well, because we're at 1, we'll be over 1, up 1. Okay, so that's good. Not too bad. This one will be over, so to the right by 1, and then up by 2. And then these down here will be symmetric. There. So here, x is negative 1 and y is 2, so we're going to go up 2, but then we're going to go over 1. Because x is negative 1 and we've squared that, we go to the right 1. So, like so. Good. Then for this one, x is 2, so we'll go to the right by 4, and we'll go up 2. So over 4, up 2. Okay, very nice. This one will go up 1, over 1. Okay, and then these will be symmetric. Okay, last two. Down 1 over 4. this one will be up 1 over 4. Oh, that's only 3. Well, that's what I get for doing it in pen. So that one goes. Interesting. Okay. Okay, so we want to show that the diagonals bisect each other. Well, here's the main trick, is that this is the main diagonal is x plus y. That's its formula. And then this one, if we consider this one to be pointing that direction, or what does the instruction say? First traveling y, then travel. Okay, yeah. So then we're to do this, we'll do negative y plus x. So this other diagonal is negative y plus x. Find the midpoint of the main diagonal, so for point A, that's easy enough. That would be x plus y over 2. That's just obvious. And then part B, well, the midpoint of the other diagonal would be, you take y, and then you add to it half of that one, so that'd be negative y plus x, and then divide by 2. And then simplifying this, this would be 2y over 2, and then plus negative y plus x. And then add those together, that's y plus x over 2. And of course, these are the same. Which is what we were trying to show. That the midpoint of this diagonal is the same as that one.